right. Hello, everyone. Thank you so much for joining us. Welcome to the Making a Media Plan breakout session. I'm Flannery Winchester, CCL's Communications Director, and we've got 30 minutes together today to build up some media skills. So we're going to go along fairly quickly, but the session will be recorded so you can go back through it later if you need to. If you have questions, please type them in the chat to my colleague, Steve Valk, who is also on the communications team, and he will answer as many as we can. Okay, so first, let's set the scenario. Imagine that your local CCL chapter just had great attendance at this conference, and you've had successful virtual lobby meeting with your member of Congress. And now you want to get the word out in local media about your chapter's work and the good prospects for climate action in 2021. Especially since we expect the Energy Innovation and Carbon Dividend Act to be reintroduced in the House early in the new Congress. So this is essentially your message for media. And in this breakout session today, we are going to walk through the steps of making a media plan to share that message in a variety of ways. So first, we'll talk about identifying outlets in your community where you want to see stories or information about CCL. Then we'll understand how to get the word out in the right way. And then we'll practice conveying the message effectively in interviews or meetings with members of the media, which we will actually practice a little bit. So we're going to start by brainstorming your ideal media. And by that, I mean, think about where you want to see information or stories about CCL and climate solutions like carbon fee and dividend. So we're actually going to split up into breakout rooms to brainstorm together. And when you get to your breakout room, I encourage you to focus on media in your community. So think about your local media and get as specific as possible. So think about, like, is there a particular local radio show with a certain host who might be interested in climate change? Or maybe there's a nightly TV news station that you watch and that you would like to do a story about your chapter. So get really specific about what you're envisioning. And then you can also get creative. Maybe there's like a columnist in your local paper who people really listen to. And if you could get that person to talk more about climate, that would be really influential. Or maybe there's a local magazine that could do a profile story about your group leader. So get creative. We're gonna have a few minutes to brainstorm these ideas. And I encourage you to write them down so that you can expand on them later, share them with your chapter. And in the breakout session, or in the little breakout rooms, share your ideas with the other folks in your breakout room and listen to their ideas, because maybe their ideas could work for you too. So we're going to take 5 minutes in the breakouts. All right. And then for those of us who are still in this main room, computer or something, or you're on a phone, doesn't allow for you to join a breakout room. So you can stay here and we'll do the same kind of thing. Steve, you can stay here with us if you want, or you can go to a breakout room. So who wants to start? Who wants to start with a little brainstorming about where in your local media you might want to see stories or information about CCL? Any ideas? Sure. So where are you calling in from? What are some of your ideas for your local media?
So I'm a part of the Silicon Valley East chapter. I was thinking of maybe contacting high schools. I think it's good to start young with getting people engaged in the community. And so maybe contacting the teachers who may teach about American government or the environmental science teachers, and just letting them know about CCL's work. And it could even be a suggested assignment for students or extra credit.
Yeah, a lot of high schools may have a newspaper, or maybe they have a blog or website where they talk about things. And so you could maybe work with some students to get a story about CCL in a school newspaper, something like that. Awesome, thank you for sharing. So I think I saw Patricia's hand. Did you want to share something, Patricia? What are some ideas you have for your local media?
Well, mainly we contact via the local newspapers. You know, I'm in southwestern Connecticut, so sort of Fairfield County. So anyway, all the newspapers along here are all kind of interconnected. They're all part of the Hearst organization. So if one if something gets published in one of their newspapers, it tends to get published in all of them, which are a whole group of papers along this southwestern southern and southwestern corner. So that is sort of exceptional to get an op-ed, but it really it's good because it has a lot more clout. In the past, you know, a few of us have got letters published in some of these publications. So that's generally what we do if we do anything with the media.
And yeah, the op-eds are fantastic and really high value. And and hopefully this presentation today will give you some ideas of other places that you could think about expanding that media work and building on that great foundation that you've already set.
Right. Yeah, great.
Okay. And Bob, I think we've got folks who will be coming back from our breakout rooms, but Bob, you want to share quickly? I've unmuted you.
We actually have a weekly newspaper that seems to be read a lot because it's free and you get it at the supermarket, as opposed in addition to the other papers. So that's one that covers our fairly rural area. But it seems like we need to, more than the newspapers, we need to do more with media, maybe putting stuff on YouTube or getting some other media. I don't watch television, so I know there's a whole group of people that watch TV to appeal to, but I think there are a lot that don't watch TV. They watch Netflix, right? So.
Yeah, well, that's a great segue into the rest of the presentation. We'll talk about some other ways to expand into different areas of the media. So thank you, Bob.
You're welcome.
All right, and it looks like we've got people back from our breakout. So I will go ahead and share again my screen. But thank you everybody for spending those few minutes brainstorming. And I'd love if folks could just put a few of your ideas in the chat. If you wanna share some of your ideas for places in your local media that you'd like to see stories, feel free to put those in the chat. Okay, so once you have brainstormed what kinds of media you want to see, then you need to understand the right way to get your information out there. So depending on where you want your message to show up, you'll need to use some different resources to be most effective. And keep in mind that your post-conference media plan might focus on just one of these areas, or it may include opportunities in all of these areas. It just depends on your chapter's capacity, really. So just keep that in mind as you develop your unique plan. But let's take a closer look at each of these areas. If your brainstorm included ideas like, I want to see CCL on the nightly news, or I want to hear about CCL in a story on my local NPR station, those are things that you're going to make happen by preparing a press release. So a press release is usually one page or so, and it gives the key points of a story. It includes quotes that reporters can easily grab and put into their stories, and it also identifies people who could be interviewed further. And so to help you out with this, CCL has created a press release template. We've actually already got it posted on CCL Community, and it's a press release template about this conference. So you can download that template, and we'll drop the link in the chat, and you can add local details to it and then use that to try to generate a story. So you want to think about things like how many local people attended this conference, how many people from your community showed that they were interested in this information. Also things like, what activities has your chapter done this year? What have you guys been up to? What are you planning to do in the new year? So you can weave those specifics into a press release, and that will steer reporters in the right direction for a story about your chapter. And then you'll identify some specific reporters at the outlets that you chose, such as reporters who cover energy or cover Congress, or maybe even reporters who just cover community activities. And then you'll send those reporters your press release, and if they're interested in doing a story, they'll contact you. So that's one thing that might be part of your media plan. Then another area you might have thought about, you might have said something like, well, I want my newspaper to talk about climate change more, or maybe I want my newspaper to actually endorse the Energy Innovation Act, to take a position on this legislation. If that's part of what you want to include in your media plan, then what you'll need is an editorial packet. And so it's kind of a similar approach. You'll be sending someone in the media some information, but these editorial packets are longer. They're 5 or 6 pages, and they give more background information that will pretty deeply inform someone about CCL and our work. And these are things that I and my colleague Steve create for you. So we gather all the information, make it really easy for you to send it out to an editorial board or to maybe a columnist or someone who's more of an opinion journalist. So you can send the editorial packet out to those folks. And then also we encourage you to ask for a meeting to discuss it further. So a reporter is always going to want just an interview, right? They're focused on a specific story. But an opinion journalist or an editorial board member, they're going to want to have a longer conversation. They're going to want to understand the full context around everything so that they can form their own opinion. So a meeting is great. And I'll just flag here that editorial endorsements are a really huge signal of community support and a big opportunity as we head into the new Congress, where we know that the Energy Innovation Act is going to be reintroduced in the House. So now is a great time to start reaching out with the editorial packets and meeting with editorial boards about this conference, about everything that you're doing with CCL and our ongoing work with Congress, and then getting those editorial boards primed to weigh in on the conversation. So those are the kinds of things that are really influential in your community and with your member of Congress. So I really encourage you to consider including this as part of your media plan. And then as Bob was starting to say there at the end of the breakouts, your brainstorming may include trying to get creative and think about other places you want to see information about CCL. Like you may want to see more social media buzz on Facebook or Instagram or Twitter. And if that's the case, that's great, because that's actually fully under your control. So you and your chapter members can post photos or graphics on social media about attending this conference. You can use hashtags like grassroots climate. You can tag your members of Congress, and you can get your message and your story out that way. So we have social media graphics and trainings on CCL community, if this is an element that you want to include in your media plan. So the next part of the plan that you'll need to prepare for is interviews. So reporters are definitely going to want to speak with someone to get more quotes for a story. And especially if it's a TV reporter or a radio journalist, they're going to need audio or visuals for their story. So they'll definitely want to do an interview. And even if you have other elements of your media plan, like you want to seek an editorial, then you'll need to have that meeting with the editorial board. So you'll need to be comfortable speaking about these topics. And you'll even have questions on social media. People want to learn more. So we're going to actually head back into our breakouts now and spend another few minutes practicing answering interview questions. So I've got these three basic questions up here, which I recommend you practice asking each other and answering. And we can also, Bill, if you could drop them in the chat for folks so that they could refer to them while they're in the breakouts. But we'll take another 5 minutes. And when you practice answering these questions, try to be clear, concise, and positive. Show them a little bit of that CCL optimism. So we'll take 5 more minutes to practice these mock interview questions, and then we'll come back at about, let's say 4:28. All right, so I'll stop my share. Head back into breakout rooms. All right, and anybody who's staying with us in the big room, you can be my guinea pigs. Who wants to do a little mock interview with me? Anybody? Scott, I see you're unmuted. Do you want to take a stab at it?
Sure.
All right, so I am your local journalist, Flannery Winchester from, Atlanta's NPR station. So Scott, thanks for joining me today. Can you tell me a little bit about what is Citizens Climate Lobby?
Sure. Citizens Climate Lobby is a nonprofit organization devoted to one and only one cause, and it's to help America solve climate change. And we have a very simple bipartisan approach that's supported by thousands of economists, liberals and conservatives alike, which involves charging a fee on carbon at the source, oil companies, natural gas, coal, and returning the money collected to American households on an even per capita basis. So we focus on communicating, lobbying, helping the public even understand why climate change is a threat and why this particular approach is one of the fastest, fairest, most effective ways of addressing the problem.
Nice, that was great. Anybody else wanna try? Take a stab at answering that question? It's such a deceptively simple question, but sometimes, you know, it's like, we know what CCL is, we're in it. But then when somebody asks it to you point blank like that, sometimes it's like, well, what are we? What do we do? Anybody else?
Yeah, and I'm starting to sweat now too.
it's nerve-wracking. And this is why it's so good to practice.
Because,
because
it's harder than you think.
Yeah, it really is. Bob, you want to try?
Sure, I'll give it a try.
All right. You want me to feed you a question? Let me.
Sure, go ahead. Feed me the question. That would be great.
My reporter hat back on. All right, Flannery Winchester here, reporting for Atlanta's local NPR station. Bob, thanks for joining us. Can you tell us a little bit about what is Citizens Climate Lobby?
Well, I'm here in Maine, and we have our own local group. Citizens Climate Lobby is a what I'd like to think of as a nonpartisan group directly involved with what we can do about climate change with our elected officials. And there are chapters in all the states around the country. So we have meetings with our elected representatives and encourage them to support our main, our main plan is to do carbon fee and dividend. So carbon, all the sources of carbon, coal, natural gas, oil, and the rest, have a fee put on them. And in return, all of the money that is collected from that fee comes back as a dividend to all the people of the United States. It doesn't get stuck in the government. It comes back to all of us on a per capita basis. And we're trying to encourage in this Congress, we're excited about what's coming up here in January with a new Congress to be able to have our meetings. And we are actually having meetings next week with our elected representatives to encourage them to support the bill that we are fully involved with.
I think the phrase that might be useful for you is our preferred policy solution or our preferred policy approach, like something like that.
Preferred policy approach. Okay.
Yeah, it really is. When you try it, it's harder than it looks. Awesome. Well, thank you guys for taking a stab at it. I think we'll put a link in the chat after this that has, we have a resource on CCL community that's called Interview Talking Points. And so there are a few just like really tight bullet points that you can have. So if you do secure a TV or radio interview, you can have that, especially if it's radio, you can have it right in front of you. If it's TV, you can memorize it and have it. Bill just put it in the chat. But yeah, so we have Interview Talking Points. Yeah, Carol.
Yeah, I wanted to know if, because I know that the fee is enacted in Europe. I don't know where, but, and I'm kind of new to CCL, but we never talk about the success rate of that philosophy or that policy. Isn't that something that would talk to the congressman about?
In this breakout, we're talking to media. And so that's probably more specific than most reporters would be ready to hear. But yes, that's good. Oh, okay. That would be good to share. Okay.
I thought maybe that would just be part of their piece.
Yeah, depends on the piece. Okay, so we've got everybody back from our breakout room. So thank you everybody for practicing that. I'll share my screen again. Actually, let me go back one second. I do just want to acknowledge that you might have found it a little harder than expected to be clear about this stuff, to be concise. It really does take practice. So Bill has put in the chat an interview talking points resource that we have on CCL Community. So you can take that and practice with other folks in your chapter, get to where you really have these talking points nailed, you've got them on the tip of your tongue. And then you can also expand on those talking points to include additional local information so that you're really ready to give a good interview that is really tied to your local community. So once you've taken all these steps, hopefully it will yield the ideal media coverage that you envisioned at the beginning. And then once you actually get a media hit, then you just want to wrap up the process by including these few final steps in your media plan. You want to thank the reporter or the editorial board or whoever it was that was involved in that media hit. If you can maintain a positive, friendly relationship with them, it will help you generate more media in the future. You want to log your media hits in the action tracker on CCL Community. So that way your other chapter members, your group leader, your regional coordinators can see that and they can celebrate with you. And then you also want to send the media to your liaison so they can make sure that your member of Congress sees it. And then you can share it on social media to get as much mileage out of it as possible. So just a super quick review to recap what we've gone over. So first, your message. After this conference, you want to go out and you want to tell media, our chapter members just attended a national climate conference and lobbied our members of Congress about climate change. We're ready for big national climate legislation in 2021, and we're working to make it happen. And then the plan to make that happen is you'll identify your ideal media. So that's what we started in our first little small group brainstorm. You can expand on that with your chapter. You want to send the message to those outlets in the appropriate format. So we put those resources in the chat for you. You can find them all on CCL Community. You want to be prepared to answer questions from the media. So practice your interview skills, continue practicing with your chapter. You want to wrap up with those final steps and then rinse and repeat as needed. So you can update the message anytime you have something new going on with your chapter. Maybe you're planning an event, maybe your member of Congress did something. You can update your message and then go through and create a new plan to get that message out. So I will stop my share now and we will take some questions. If you can chat your questions to Steve. Steve, do you have any flag that you want to ask out loud? We've got a couple minutes here at the end. Okay, cool. I do see one question in the chat to me from Lisa. She's saying for folks who are not really into social media or not interested in using Facebook, is that okay to skip that and to not make that part of your media plan? Of course, I think that there may be people in your chapter who are interested in that, so you could loop them in and they could own that piece of it. But if you are more comfortable, you know, prioritizing radio or TV or your newspaper, you can certainly focus on those areas. That's totally fine. You don't have to do every single area that's possible.
Okay, we got a question from Ken Kirby. Is anyone buying small ad space to maybe grow your group? Is that possible? Flannery, you want to maybe touch on Google Ads or something like that? Because they do offer, free ads for nonprofits and stuff.
That's a good question. I mean, I would say CCL's power is really, organized people more so than organized money. So I would say that unless you just want to spend money on ads and you want to try that route, I would say try the not paid routes of the media and see what you can make happen. Because something like an article that talks about your chapter is going to be a really good recruitment tool for you. And that's something that you can use for months afterward to say, hey, look, we were covered in the Times and, whatever your local newspaper is. And you can flash that around and it really gives you some extra credibility. So you're welcome to try paid ad space if that's something that you have funds that you want to dedicate to. But I think that in terms of recruitment, like an earned media piece, like an article or a story on the radio or something would go a long way toward meeting that goal.
Let's see, we have another. What is the most effective way to use Facebook? To use Facebook and Twitter, for example, posting links to op-eds. I'll answer that. It's basically what you can use social media for is to leverage the successes that you get with print media by tweeting, particularly tweeting about letters to the editor your group has published or op-eds or something like that, and be sure to tag your members of Congress, your representative and your senators, so that they'll see that media too. But that's a great way to leverage your print media is through social media.
Yeah, absolutely. All right, and I'll just share this last slide here. We're at 4:35, so it's the end of our time together, but thank you everybody for being here. There's my contact information. If you have other questions, feel free to reach out to me. This is what I'm here for. This is what Steve's here for, is to make sure that you guys can be successful out there generating local media about climate change, about CCL, about climate solutions. So feel free to reach out and thank you so much. We will see you over in the closing keynote session here in a few minutes. All right, thanks.
Thank you for listening to this episode of Citizens Climate Lobby's training program. You can tune into more episodes anywhere podcasts are available. Inspired by what you heard today? Join Citizens Climate Lobby to advocate for bipartisan climate solutions. Go to community.citizensclimate.org to find more trainings, resources, your local chapter, national action teams, discussion forums, and more. Be sure to like our Facebook page and follow us on Twitter and Instagram at Citizens Climate. We also invite all of our listeners to subscribe to our YouTube channel for more inspiration. And together, we are creating the political will for a livable world.